The Boolean modifier allows Boolean operation as a modifier. This modifier brings an intuitive, art-directable workflow that facilitates procedural modeling and interactivity, while producing clean, geometric output. Let's check the supported Boolean types first. Apply Boolean modifier. Select the blue subtract type button in the Add Operand rollout. Pick the green box. The green box cuts the yellow box. Go to the Operand List rollout and select Box B. You can see the Box B as a blue transparent gizmo, which is the same color as the color in the button. Click the subtract icon of the Box B. You can change the Boolean type. Choose Intersect. The Boolean operation changes. So does the gizmo color. Change to Union. The gizmo changed to green. Two boxes are combined as one. Now let's get to more interesting types. Change the Boolean type to split. It looks like it did something, but it is a little bit hard to see what exactly happened. Let's try the Explode Elements Data Channel Modifier preset, which is added in 3ds Max 2024.2. Add a data channel modifier. Open the Presets dropdown and choose Explode Elements. Press the Load button. Turn off Enable Display to see the original color. This will also update the viewport. Now you can clearly see what the split operation did. It's a combination of intersect and subtract. This type is very convenient for breaking objects. In the past, you would need to copy the operands and do two Boolean operations for one slice. Now it can be done in one click. We will check this type later again. Merge is similar to split. The yellow box is A and the green box is B. Split was a minus B and intersect. Merge adds B minus A to split. The color for merge is purple. The attach function is straightforward. It doesn't alter anything. It simply merges all operands into a single object as they are. If you want to attach multiple objects procedurally, you can use this type. Insert return subtract while leaving the shape of operand B unchanged. The color is red. There are two more options that affect the result shape: imprint and cookie. Turn on imprint. This option only adds intersection edges between the operands, similar to the refine function in the slice modifier. Turn off imprint and turn on cookie. This is a cookie cutter option which just cuts a hole in the mesh. All right, so we've looked at the types of operations you can do with a Boolean modifier. Now let's talk about something important: capture and live reference. By default, Boolean captures the mesh and transform of the operands into the modifier. As you can see, when you pick the operand, it disappears from the scene. In the operand list, you can see it has the box shape captured icon. Even though you transform the Boolean object, the shape doesn't change since all the operands are embedded in the object. Select all the operands. Right-click and extract operand. This feature allows you to extract the captured operands as scene objects again. Now check Use Live Reference and we will pick operands again. Pay attention to the Scene Explorer. As you pick each operand, they become hidden and remain in the scene. If we move around the Boolean object, the operand transform will not follow the Boolean object. The icon is also different. The icon for capture was a closed box. The icon for live reference is an open box. If you want to use the Boolean modifier for modeling, you would capture the operands. If you want to use the Boolean modifier for animation, you would use live reference. Keep in mind that you cannot switch between capture and live reference modes later. You must enable or disable the Use Live Reference checkbox before adding operands. If an operand has already been captured, you will need to extract it and add it as a live reference again. Now, let's go over the overall workflow through a simple modeling task. Let me pick the material of base geometry at slot 1 first. I'm subtracting this from base and want to add chamfer 0.3. Add Boolean modifier. Turn on subtract. Pick this one. Add poly select. Look at this. The modifier automatically added the edge selection for intersecting edges. We can utilize this edge selection for chamfer. Add a chamfer and set amount to 0.3 and use selected edges for selection. Let's save this as preset so we can use later again. Add another poly select. You can see that chamfer also automatically selected the chamfered edges. However, we don't want this for the next chamfer, so let's clear them. Subtract the next operand. This one has a different material. Let me pick the material again. You can now see it has a multi-sub material with two materials, one from the base and one from the operand. This is because the Use Material button is enabled. When this button is on, the Boolean modifier automatically creates a multi-sub material and assigns material IDs. If you want to keep the original material IDs, turn off this button. Add another chamfer and load the preset we saved. Change the amount to 0.2. Let me add the remaining operands. Add another chamfer and load the preset we saved. Change the amount to 0.2. Add poly select and clear the edge selection. Add another boolean and pick the last operand. Add a chamfer and load the preset we saved. Change the amount to 0.1. Let's check the material again. You can see all the material from the new operands. Now, what if I want a few more orange boxes? Go back to the last Boolean modifier and select the box operand. Then, shift drag copy just like any object. By the way, did you notice that the stack history changes when you select a captured operand? Even though the operand is captured, you can still access its history, which is pretty cool but potentially confusing. Therefore, if the stack is displaying the history of an operand other than the base object, a thick teal line will appear under the Boolean modifier to indicate this. You can always go back and change your mind thanks to the power of the modifier stack. The operand list window can be resized. In the operand list, you can drag and drop to change the process order. You can also enable and disable an operand. Or delete it. In this modifier, we've got five operands, and it's tough to tell which is which just by their names. Here is the Manipulate Operand button for you. If you press the button, colored dot gizmos for each operand appear. If you select an operand by selecting the dot, you can also see that the selection in the operand list is updated. Right-clicking on the dot gizmo will bring up the operand right-click menu. You can do almost everything you do in the operand list here, such as changing the Boolean type, changing transform type, enabling and disabling the operand and deleting it, etc. Now, select multiple operands and press the Create a Folder button. This allows you to group the selected operands into a folder, which functions like a single operand. You can turn it on or off, or change its type as one entity. That wraps up the basic workflow. Now, let's explore some unique features of the Boolean modifier. I have two objects, a box and an array of planes with noise modifiers. Let me split the box with it. And add a data channel explode elements preset. As you can see, the Boolean modifier splits the box with each plane recursively. In the past, this could only be accomplished through scripting. It is also fully procedural. If you want each piece as its own object, just press the Create Objects button. Lastly, this Boolean modifier supports not only Mesh Boolean, but also OpenVDB-based Volume Boolean. Go to Options Rollout and change the method from Mesh to OpenVDB. Then change voxel size to 0.25. For Volume Boolean, only three types are supported: Union, Intersect, and Subtract. Pick each operands. You can see all the primitives are merged together. Now let's add some more details. Make a reference copy. Delete faces at the bottom and the top using Volume Select Modifier and Delete Mesh Modifier, so we can keep everything procedural. Add Retopology Modifier and pre-process to 2000 faces. We will use this as a distribution source for the Array Modifier. The pre-process mode is perfect for this, since it generates evenly distributed triangles. Make a cube octahedra with radius 1. Add an array modifier. Set to surface. Pick the referenced and modified column object. Then remove 75% of them. Randomize the scale. Now we just need to subtract this from the original column model. However, the Boolean does not allow this to be used as an operand due to the circular dependency. The array is derived from the original column, and attempting to change the array's distribution source results in a chicken and egg scenario. What we can do is add another Boolean above reference. Then subtract from there. That looks good. Again, everything is procedural. You can always go back and change anything you want. Then use a retopology modifier to get clean quads. That concludes our Boolean tutorial. Thanks for watching.